The gentleman's time has expired.
Thank you.
Congressman Fartenberry from Nebraska.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Hello, Ms. Secretary. Thank you for joining us today. In your testimony, you stated that you would like Congress to create a new regulatory framework to be able to intervene and facilitate the orderly wind down of a systemically important institution. What do you envision?
Well, I think something very similar to what has been suggested by the Obama administration makes sense, because there needs to be, when there is a real systemic risk, so this should not be done frivolously, when the system is at risk, there needs to be a way to avoid the normal bankruptcy process and let a regulatory body come in and handle the wind down of the liabilities in such a way as it does not prevent a real danger to the public and the financial system. And if we have a different regulatory regime, and if this authority is structured properly, then we won't be in a situation where institutions are too big to fail.
Well, in that regard, what role do you foresee for the Treasury, for the Fed, for the FDIC?
Well, there have been a number of things that have been suggested. What we had suggested as part of the regulatory blueprint was the Fed playing the role of a macro stability regulator, being able to look across the whole economy and look across the capital markets for risks, being able to access and get information, and having the authorities to act. In terms of the wind down, if there's a potential failure, I think there needs to be a high bar. So there would need to be a determination by the Secretary of the Treasury, by the Chairman of the Fed, by other regulators, that there is a true systemic issue. So this should not be an easy bar to get over. But when there is, then the regulator needs all of the powers to handle that wind down.
Given all of the turmoil in the economy in the last year, given the government's intervention, we're now left with the reality that 10 banks in this country control about 50% of the deposited assets. Is that a systemic risk, in your view?
It is something that makes me uncomfortable.
So how would we proceed? How would this new regulatory framework look at that potential situation?
Well, as I said, I'm just only going to deal with things that I said. I'm saying nothing now that I didn't say when I was Treasury Secretary. We put forward a regulatory blueprint which called for greater consolidation of banking regulation as opposed to the multiple regulators. And so I think having greater consolidation and stronger regulation coupled with the wind down powers so that you don't have banks or bank holding companies being too big to fail, I think is a meaningful way of dealing with the risk, because in my judgment, a regulation, no matter how good, is always going to be imperfect. And so you need to have it in balance with the market discipline or moral hazard, that we got to a point where we couldn't rely on market discipline or moral hazard because it would have taken the system down. But to the extent the infrastructure in the financial markets are fixed, and I'm talking about the tri-party repo market, credit default swaps, and there's a lot of work that's been done there, and you have the wind-down powers, and so then we're not held hostage by institutions that are too big to fail, I think there's an opportunity to get the balance right.
Just to let you know, we've changed the expression too big to fail to too big to succeed, and that's part of the intention that I have in simply asking you the question. Are we now in a place where we, because of debatable actions, and I've heard you clearly in your justifications, and I'm not trying to play gotcha here or anything, just looking ahead to say, are we now in a situation where the actions that were taken to try to stabilize the economy has left us with further vulnerability and the potential for a systemic failure because of this highly concentrated control of the financial system in the hands of a few?
I understand your question. And there's going to be, because when you look at the number of banks, there's going to be a lot more consolidation before we're done. But I do understand your question, and I think it's important we get this in balance.
All right. Thank you, Secretary.
Time has expired.